My name is Mahalakshmi Vedikaran and my mental number is 181887. My final year project's title is Thermophilic Biohydrogen Production by Immobilized Cell on Aquarium Sponge. My supervisor is Dr. Nurshakina Binti Jamali and my FIP coordinator is Dr. Sinia Idati Binti Muhammad Rashid. Contents are introduction, problem statement, objectives, methodology, results and discussion, conclusion and finally recommendation. As for introduction, biohydrogen is a clean fuel from renewable sources of energy. It is a high energy yield and is 2.75 times greater than hydrocarbon fuel energy yield. Dark fermentation is used in the production of hydrogen. Malaysia generates 0.6 to 0.65 meter cube of bromine, which is known as palm oil meal effluent, with every 1 ton of fresh fruit branch. Bromine have a mixture of carbohydrate-free organic acids, amino acids, inorganic nutrients such as sodium, potassium, calcium, magnesium, short fibers, organic and nitrogen components, so we can use it as substitute for the production of biohydrogen. Problem statement. Bromine becomes huge issue for palm oil industry and it is a highly polluting wastewater causing serious problem to the environment. Thus, to overcome this problem, production of biohydrogen from bromine have been introduced. Biohydrogen production can be done through thermophilic dark fermentation process as it has the ability to produce high yield. Thermophilic fermentation is much better than most mesophilic fermentation because mesophilic produce high rate of acetate and butyrate. Immobilized cell system have become common alternative to suspended cell system in continuous operation and can be operated at high dilution rate without encountering washout of cells. The immobilization cell system also gifted with the feature of creating a local anaerobic environment which is well suited to oxygen sensitive dark hydrogen fermentation. So for this experiment, immobilized cell system have been used. Objective: to determine the hydrogen production using immobilized cell on sponge as microbial support carrier at thermophilic fermentation, and to determine the hydrogen production at different concentration of bromine with different amount of sponge immobilized cells. Methodology: there are 5 steps: inoculum cultivation, sponge as microbial carrier, preparation of synthetic medium, biohydrogen production, and finally analysis. As for inoculum cultivation, mixed culture of bromine sludge was collected from a sludge feed or processing mill. The microbial sludge undergoes heat treatment process at 80 degrees Celsius for 60 minutes to inactivate the growth of methanogenic population. The mixed culture of microbe was cultured in synthetic medium at 60 degrees Celsius. Sponge as microbial carrier. Sponge is used as microbial carrier for immobilization process. In the acclimatization phase, the microbes are able to attach themselves to the surface of aquarium sponge and preparation of synthetic medium, followed by biohydrogen production with different concentration of bromine and different percentage of sponge attached by film. Finally, analysis is, there are 4 different type of analysis have been conducted. First is total carbohydrate, followed by analysis of biohydrogen gas, total suspended solid, and finally volatile suspended solid. Now I would like to talk about results and discussion. First is biofilm development using sponge as carrier. Microbes undergo acclimatization process under thermophilic temperature. Thermophilic temperature is 60 degrees Celsius, which is the most suitable temperature to produce high amount of biogas. The main objective of acclimatization is to attach microbes on the surface of aquarium sponge, and the overall acclimatization process took 33 days. Next is biohydrogen production from acclimatization of mixed culture on sponge. Biohydrogen production at day 1 was found to be 750 ml of biogas, and the result was consistent to the following days. The biogas collected in reverse measuring cylinder as shown in figure 2. This had proved that there is an improvement in the growth of microbes. Starting from day 15 until day 27, there is an improvement in HPR, and last 5 days, which is from day 28 to day 33, the HPR remains same. Highest amount of biogas produced is 980 ml and the lowest amount of biogas produced is 750 ml. High volume of biogas produced during stationary phase and low volume of biogas at initial stage. At initial stage, less volume of biogas were produced because microbe is still new to the environment, and it start to produce high amount of biogas at stationary phase because microbe is completely adapted to the new environment. Selection of best concentration of bromine. This experiment have been conducted with different percentage of bromine, which is 20%, 40%, 60%, 80%, and 100% of bromine. Experiment, we can conclude that 60% of bromine managed to produce high amount of biogas and biohydrogen gas. From this experiment, we can identify that microbes can be more active at 60% of bromine compared to other percentage of bromine. effect of immobilized cells percentage to optimal Fermi ratio as fermentation substrate. This experiment has been conducted with different percentage of sponge attached by film, which is 10%, 15%, 20%, 25%, and 30%. Fixed percentage of Fermi, which is 60% of Fermi. From this experiment, we can conclude that 30% of sponge attached by film managed to produce high amount of biogas and biohydrogen gas. This had proved that microbe can produce more hydrogen if it has large percentage of sponge attached by it. Now I would like to talk about total carbohydrate analysis. Ferrite sulfuric method has been used to determine total carbohydrate. The amount of TC decreases as time increases. The reduction of TC showed that microbes start to consume glucose inside the Fermi. Total carbohydrate for different concentration of Fermi. From this graph, we can conclude that 100% of Fermi contain high amount of glucose compared to other percentage of Fermi. Next, this graph is showing total carbohydrate with different percentage of sponge attached by film. From this graph, we can identify there is a high amount of TC deduction in 30% of attached by film. This is because high amount of attached by film contain high amount of microbe and it consume more glucose compared to other percentage of attached by film. So this result illustrates that high amount of microbe need high amount of glucose for it to produce more biohydrogen gas. Next, I'd like to talk about total suspended solid and volatile suspended solid at different concentration of Fermi. TSS have been decreased until 19 double. This is because microbe will be active at this phase, which is known as exponential phase, and microbe tend to use more glucose in Fermi for its growth. 100% of Fermi contain high amount of TSS because it is a pure Fermi. The higher the percentage of Fermi diluted with distilled water, the lower the amount of total suspended solid it contains. Volatile suspended solid for different concentration of Fermi. Volatile suspended have been increased until 19 tau. At 19 tau, 100% of Fermi had high amount of volatile suspended solid. After 19 tau, volatile suspended solid reduced and remained stationary because microbes start to attach back to sponge. According to Spitz, low biomass value showed that cell won't wash out easily. Next is total suspended solid and volatile suspended solid for different percentage of sponge attached by film. 30% of sponge attached by film contain high amount of total suspended solid. The amount of total suspended solid have been decreased until 19 tau. This is because microbe use glucose in the Fermi to gain energy and for its growth factor. The amount of total suspended solid decreases as the percentage of attached by film decreases. Next is volatile suspended solid for different percentage of attached by film. The amount of VSS has been decreasing until 19 tau. This is because microbe will be active at this phase and detach from occurring sponge. After 19 tau, the amount of VSS decreases and reaches steady state. This had showed that microbe had attached back to occurring. As a conclusion, microbe can adapt to 60% of Fermi compared to other percentage of Fermi. From this, we can justify that microbe can adapt to 60% of Fermi as it contains medium amount of glucose. Microbe can produce more biogas at 30% of attached by film. Furthermore, the growth of microbe increased until 19 tau, and this is known as exponential phase. At this particular time, microbes slowly become active and detach from aquarium sponge and start to consume glucose in Fermi. After 19 tau, microbe attach back to aquarium sponge and reach stationary phase. This had been proved that through VSS analysis, 100% of Fermi and 30% of sponge attached by film contain higher amount of total suspended solid. The higher the concentration of Fermi and the percentage of sponge attached by film, the higher the amount of total suspended solid. As a conclusion, 30% of sponge attached by film and 60% of Fermi is the most suitable environment for microbes to adapt and produce high amount of biohydrogen gas. Recommendation: this study can be further improved by testing microbes with different type of carrier. The size and type of carrier can influence biohydrogen gas production. This experiment can be improved by testing microbes with food-based, since food-based contains glucose. Microbes can be tested with different temperature and pH. This experiment can be tested with heterotrophic bacteria, as this bacteria also can produce more hydrogen gas. That's all from me. Thank you.